An 18-year-old, previously healthy student has had a fever of up to 38.4 degrees Celsius and a dry cough for 4 days now. He thought it was the flu and that it would go away, but now he's had enough, so he comes to see his doctor. He is a bit tired, but isn't experiencing any shortness of breath, chest pain, or any other severe symptoms. Upon examination, his vitals are normal. Even his temperature is normal because he has just taken paracetamol. Lung auscultation is also unremarkable, but since there's been no improvement in 4 days, the doctor orders a chest x-ray just to be sure. And sure enough, it's pneumonia. The doctor prescribes oral amoxicillin in accordance with the guidelines. However, after 3 days, the patient comes back. He is still not getting better. The fever is still present, as is the dry cough. The doctor examines him once again and the findings are virtually identical to those from 3 days ago. The x-ray is also unchanged. What should the doctor do? A. Wait a few more days to give the antibiotic time to work. B. Switch to another antibiotic regimen right away. And C. Send the patient to a hospital for more extensive workup like CT and cultures. A few seconds to think. Well, 3 days is enough time for antibiotics to take effect. If there is no improvement by then, something is not right. Our patient is really not getting better. The good news, however, is that he is not getting worse either. Pneumonia caused by a virulent pathogen that is not covered by amoxicillin like Staphylococcus aureus would have become much more severe by now. This doesn't seem to be the case here. The patient's vitals are still normal, there are no signs of complications, and there are absolutely no signs of pleural effusion or empyema on the chest x-ray. Whatever is causing this, it does not seem to be very virulent. Therefore, I would not plan hospitalization just yet. Instead, I would switch the antibiotic regimen. Most guidelines for the treatment of community-acquired pneumonia recommend amoxicillin as first-line treatment for outpatients. Why amoxicillin? Well, because it reliably covers Streptococcus pneumoniae, the most common and one of the most severe causes of pneumonia. That is the pathogen we are all worried about, so we always make sure that we cover it first. But this patient is not responding to amoxicillin. Why is that? Well, probably because he has what we used to call atypical pneumonia. What makes it atypical is the fact that the pathogens that cause it, most commonly Mycoplasma pneumoniae, do not respond to beta-lactams like amoxicillin. They are, however, killed by macrolides like azithromycin or clarithromycin or tetracyclines like doxycycline. Mycoplasma pneumoniae seems to be the most probable explanation here. A young person with no chronic diseases, pneumonia that is not severe, interstitial infiltrates on chest x-ray, and the lack of response to amoxicillin. All of this points to mycoplasma. So, I would discontinue amoxicillin and start doxycycline or clarithromycin. Naturally, I would tell my patient to return for a checkup in a few days to make sure that everything is okay. Mycoplasma is by far the most likely explanation, but it's still a guess and a follow-up is in order. In conclusion, yes, amoxicillin is still the mainstay of treatment for outpatients with community-acquired pneumonia. But if your patient is infected with one of these atypical pathogens, they will not respond to amoxicillin. A young patient with no chronic diseases who presents with a fever and a dry cough but is not severely ill and has a mild interstitial infiltrate on chest x-ray with no neutrophilia in the CBC should make you think of mycoplasma. Every 5 to 8 years there is typically an outbreak, so you are likely to see several patients like this in a short period of time, which should make the diagnosis even easier. This is the kind of stuff you will learn in my online course on antibiotics. In the description of this video, you will find the link to the demo version that contains the first few crucial lessons that explain the most important group of antibiotics and provide a great foundation for everything that follows. If you use antibiotics in clinical practice, take a look at this course. I hope I see you there. Take care.